Today we will see the block diagram of DVD. Why I had chosen the block diagram of DVD? Because you can modify this block diagram, and you can same block diagram you can draw for CD also and Blu-ray also. It is very simple block diagram. Here you can see that it is a input for our block diagram. Till now, all the block diagram which we saw had input as sensors and output as its transmitter, that is antenna. When it comes to the DVD player, actually here the input is not shown, but input is going to be a sensor, and that sensor will be an IR sensor or a Blu-ray sensor if it is a Blu-ray disc. Here what we are shown is that there is a DVD, there is a turntable. Turntable is nothing but it is actually rotating a DVD so that the all sectors of DVD will be able to read by the IR sensor. That last time I had shown you the block diagram of how the pits and the flats are read by the any CD player or DVD player. Okay, so through this assembly, what we do is that we get the information which is recorded on the CD. So these are the block diagrams for which controls this reading of the DVD. It will have the optical assembly. This optical assembly, last time we had seen that in this optical assembly we will have the laser beam generator, and also there will be a photodiode. A laser beam generator will generate a laser which will be actually bombarded on this CD or a DVD, okay, and it will get reflected back. There will be a mirror, and this mirror will act as a barrier. The reflected ray will not go back to the laser beam generator, but it will be reflected to the photodiode, so that we will see whether there is a pit or a flat. If it is a pit, it will not reflect the light. If it is a flat, it will reflect the light. Okay, so this is actually working of that. Obviously, laser power control is there, focus and tracking control is there. This assembly is for remote sensor. The DVD player or CD player might come with the remote, so it is for that. Then what we do is that whatever the data which we read from the CD, that means the ones and the zeros which are corresponding to the pits and the flats, so we convert them into the ones and the zeros. These ones and the zeros are converted by this block. Not only we convert whatever the data coming from that reflection of the light as ones and the zeros. Last time I had told you that there can be encryption technique and there can be some error correction techniques. All are applied on that, and a data stream is generated. Obviously, we record audio and the video on that. So what we do over here also, that we separate the audio and we separate the video. Video, I told you that we go for the compression. So at the receiving side, we seen in the TV system that we first decompose it. So if we are writing on the DVD and if you are reading it back, we have to decompress it. The compression technique which we use is MPEG-2 in this. Okay, so from that, after the compression, what we do is that we separate the components of the video, that is Y, U and V components of the video. And depending upon which type of encoding, which type of display technique which you are using, whether you are using NTSC or PAL, depending upon that, the signal is converted. This is to match your television set, and the yellow, the RGB might be generated, or PAL NTSC video is generated, or Y, PB or PR is generated. Depending upon which technique, whether you are going for NTSC or PAL, that is generated. Also, the audio is separately decompressed. We go for here, we go for the Dolby system, that is AC3. So we decompose that. The audio which we use in advanced TVs or in digital TV systems is the stereo. So it will have the left and right. So we go for the 5.1, that is Dolby 5.1. So it will have the surround sound. So it will have left, right, center, rear left, rear right, and subwoofer. So this is a simple block diagram. Okay, whenever you are, suppose you are going for the simple CD. So instead of DVD, you will write CD. If it is a Blu-ray, here you will write a Blu-ray, but optical, in the optical assembly, you are supposed to write that it will not be a laser, it will be visible blue light. So that changes you are supposed to make in this block diagram, and it is simple block diagram which you can draw in your system. Very important part in this is that there is a teletext, if any. So this can be subtitles, okay, subtitles for the video that can be incorporated. We had seen the different compression techniques. So MPEG-4 or MPEG-12, actually they go for the metadata. They support the metadata. So whenever we are having any higher level of compression, we can have this kind of some text, okay, so that can be fed, okay. In the subtext which we see that it can be in different languages. Also we can have the different audio incorporated in with same video. So even though it is shown that it is actually decompressing or demuxing only one audio, we can have the multiple audios over here, which might be corresponding to different languages, but the video will be same. So this is this thing you are supposed to keep in mind. Obviously there will be a CPU in a DVD player which will be controlling all the operations of the DVD.